This is my first Procreate video on YouTube. My name is Samm Leavitt, and today we're going to go over the Procreate basics, and this is going to be part one. I'm hoping to make other parts to this so that we can make sure that you feel so confident with Procreate. So first off, we're just going to go over what Procreate is, how much it costs, what the app looks like. This is my main screen. I've got Procreate down here. Procreate is a $10 app on any iOS app store for the iPad Air or iPad Pro. This is what the app looks like. It's like that little swish. We're going to create a new canvas and just hit screen size to start off our first canvas. You can do this side by side with me if you just want to click through. So we've got the actions tab where you can add photos, text, or files. You can also cut, copy, or paste if you have things selected. The next one, we've got canvases, so you can resize your canvas here. You can also do the animation guide and the drawing guide. I'll show you what each of these look like really quickly. So the drawing guide, we'll go over into that more detail in the future. You can also have a reference, so you can have it so you can have your whole canvas projected. You can add a photo there, or you can have it project on your face, which is fun. After that, these are just you can reflect the canvas, or you can learn the canvas information. So this got the DPI and the size. You can also find out how long you've worked on a specific canvas that way. This is how you export it. They've got lots of different options for that. This is how you can watch a time lapse or export your time lapse video for that canvas specifically. Next, we've got the preferences. So we've got light interface, which is light or dark. Right-hand interface for the slider tools for the size and the opacity. And then we've got the brush cursor, which I'll go into more detail in a later episode. And then we've got the project canvas, which I've never had to deal with because I don't have an Apple TV. Then we've got preferences or help, so you can learn all about different Procreate things here. They've got the handbook, leave a review. Learn to Procreate is a YouTube channel that Procreate has. Next, we have got the adjustments tab. I'm not going to go into any detail into these because they're all kind of their own specific thing, but know that's there and that we're going to go over it in another episode. The next is the selection tool. I'll go a little bit deeper into this after I add some art to the canvas, just because you have to have something on the canvas in order to make adjustments too. So first, it starts coloring, and I'm like, what the heck? It's because I have the color fill on, so it takes me a second to realize it. But the color fill is down at the bottom, so if you have that, anything you click on in that setting will fill with color. So the blue, that means that that's selected. To change your color fill, you're going to drag to the left or right. I will go into more detail into this in another YouTube episode, but this is basically it now. That makes it so you can make adjustments like coloring. You can use the adjustments tab and do lots of different stuff. I selected just the color by hitting just the ink. You can also do freestyle, trace around it to select it. You can do a rectangle. And then when you hit the cursor key, that means you can move it around. And they also have this option in an oval. Undo and redo count just the same. So two finger tap is undo, three finger tap is redo. If you did a circle, it will do the same thing. Select that. To restart it, you can just hit the selection tool, unselect it and reselect it. I've got color fill on, so now I've got the square and circle one coming up and it will fill with color, but the freestyle one does not. But the automatic selection does. The last thing I'll show you is the feathering. Actually, it's two more things. So the feathering just makes it so the selection isn't like as stark as a contrast. It kind of blends the edges. And then I'm going to delete this because it just, I hit the copy and paste, and copy and paste will copy whatever you have selected and put it into a new layer. Then you can do the remove. So if you select something with freestyle and then hit remove, it will select everything else outside of what you've selected. So you can see that I color and it doesn't color in the spot that I have selected, but we're going to just clear everything out and start anew. Next, we have got the You can also clear stuff out, and the undo is two fingers and redo is three fingers, just like I said earlier. In order to use the cursor tool, you have to have something drawn, so anything in that layer will be able to be moved or made bigger. The first one will, I think it's freeform, it will mess with it. However, uniform will keep it in the same spot. Distort will mess with it, and warp will mess with it, but it will be in different ways. I'll go into more detail in another episode just because it can be kind of overwhelming now. Next, we're going to get into brushes. There are tons of factory, just naturally there brushes, anywhere from sketching to painting to calligraphy to textures to airbrushing to spray painting, basically everything. I recommend looking through every single one of these. This one's the bubble one. It's crazy what you can do with all of these brushes. The smudge tool has all the same brushes, and it allows you to smudge or blend, kind of like if you had a pencil or a colored pencil and you smudged it with your finger or a Q-tip or something. So you can use any brush you want for that one. And then erasers the exact same way. You can erase in any which way with any brush you want. I'm still using the smudge tool in this one. Your sliders on the left-hand side are opacity and size, so you can make your brush bigger or smaller, or make the effect like basically thinner, or like if it, in the case of a paint, it like more water in a watercolor, or more like turpentine in a oil-based paint. So this is me drawing, so I can show you the opacity, see how things differ. In the layers tab, it's all based off of order. So whatever's at the top will be on top of everything else. In order to move something, just long press and drag it up. You'll see me do this in just a second. So in this one, this isn't a great example, but I color on it and then I show that it moves up and down, but it doesn't really look different because I picked really similar colors. And the heart itself is already really opaque. So in order to do that, I change the color and I show you a little bit better that basically how the order works. So I colored the layer is underneath that first green squiggle layer, and then I move it on top so you can see how the order works. I recommend just playing around with this so you can get to know it better, so you can take full advantage of it in your work. And then you can also unselect and deselect layers. I'm going to go over probably an entire episode just based off of layers, just because there's so much you can do with them and there's so many different things. This one I make a clipping mask of it, so you can basically color in it. This is me using the Alpha Lock tool, which is just a preview into the layer episode, which I'm hoping to do soon. If you have any questions specifically about that, you can put them in the comments below. I also have it, I did the color drop feature, which I used, it was Alpha Lock, so it colored the whole thing. But you grab that top circle and drag it onto wherever you want to drop color. And it will drop either in the whole canvas, or if you have stuff already drawn, it will drop it in the middle of it like it filled up the heart. Next, we've got the color wheel. So the first one is the disc. So the color shading is in the middle, and then the hue of the color is in the back. The next one, it's more of like a slider base, so you've got a bigger option for that. Next is this one, harmony. You can choose different color combos. I show you here, so you can drag them around, get your test, or you can add different shades by doing the slider at the bottom. And then the last one is probably the one I use the most other than the very first one. And this is just if you want to get really exact colors. I feel like it's really helpful. And then the last thing, if you had like a color code, you can add it into that one. You've got your color history and then your palettes. I've got tons and tons of palettes. Probably need to consolidate these someday, but not anytime soon. To add a new palette, you can just click new palette, and then whenever you have a color selected, if you tap on it, it will add color, and then if you long press on it, you can delete it. You can also set your default by just clicking the set default, and then that will show up down at the bottom of any of your other selected. And then the last one, you can add photos or files. And I just show you, I add a photo of myself that I had taken a selfie of myself, and it just adds it into its own color palette. Thank you for watching. If you have any other questions, please put them in the comments below. Thanks for being here.